you can put Mohammed, say, Papa, did you say?
You should wait for my answer, though, Al. Okay, so the argument is two strands. One, when Moses actually makes the provisions for the people to go out and kill the Amalekites, and then keeps the unmarried women for himself, and younger, wait a minute, granted by Jesus, yes, but the provision that they Moses made the arrangements, that's irrelevant, because it was still a righteous act, even
I'm not here to, point.
But the point is that it's so that the
I don't want debate.
Because a girl is not going to be pregnant unless it's 65-4. That way, you know that the tribe cannot continue because it's going to come through the male bloodline. So it's nothing to do with paedophilia. They're going to grow up before they get married. And now the reason is that Mohammed is not a prophet is nothing to do with Aisha. Not one bit. It's to do with the fact that the Bible says up until John, the law and the prophets. And after this, the kingdom is being preached and every man will violently try to make his way into it. There are no more prophets after John. Jesus prophesied, and yet he was no mere prophet. He was God in the flesh and it can be proven from the Quran.
Okay, firstly, I want to admire you for your honesty and I want to thank you for your honesty. Because what you did there is it was genuine and it was honest in the context where you said rejecting Prophet Muhammad is not based on him marrying Aisha, but based on the Bible doesn't say that. You don't hear from Christians, but I admire your honesty and that shows that there's some genuine discussion happening from both sides. And regarding this issue, which you still admitted that in the Old Testament, this is Jesus carried out by Moses, but the argument, then I can't really argue with what you're saying, because you're coming from
Barnabas was not a part of the disciples.